World War I Jimmy Ray Stephen thing.
Jimmy Ray.
Is it true that you reached out to Carson with permission to talk to Larry Sawyer?
Please continue.
The assassin.
Good thing it's recorded on Facebook Live. We can go back later and learn what was said.
We should get Austin to calm down first.
That could take a while.
Let him calm down and say it
which sounds like the Dilly years with this backdrop.
Just for that.
Won't you shut up?
Arsenal won. I know that because I just woke up to a text from Brandy talking about the text of Wes.
That's kind
of stupid.
You guys
are serious. Which is
the puppeteer?
I was like on it right away. I missed it. What was it?
Yeah.
He was like, man, like, Arsenal can't even beat a team at the bottom of the table. They're in the relegation zone. I texted Wes not being awake yet, of course.
Yes.
Reply until 1 o'clock.
And then suddenly becomes nominal. That's not
yes.
Was previously not nominal.
It was very obvious what was going on.
Because I watched Rangers boys flub a game on Saturday.
The flub game?
Crystal Palace. The Palace, is that what they call themselves? Is that what you call them? Okay. The Fighting Brent Rangers threw away a game. Big win for my beloved players. Big win.
He takes me when they're down 1-0 saying I need a new team. Should have
responded with the
I would be a fan of the new team.
What?
Look forward to 2 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Teams not the Premier League. Is over his way, just like Arsenal's profile.
Mm.
just enough to lose.
Yeah, Matt,
I'm going to do that one. I don't want his microbrewery.
It's being shot for real.
I think you need to add a twist.
Josh, you got time to brew beer?
No, it really isn't. Well, it's time.
Yeah, I mean, all things.
It's 6:44.
It's still crazy, but not.
It's officially late. We're officially going down in there. Series hustling in here.
Send the can at Ole Miss. It was very selfish.
Which was probably the best home good idea Mike's ever had. Hold my coffee to send the can at Ole Miss.
He wouldn't know that.
Let's talk about Taylor.
You said he weighs too much to send the can.
I didn't.
You're 200 now?
Oh, we would.
205. He's at 205. We're on 15s since basketball season ended.
Yeah.
I'm working out pretty hard. You're
lifting pretty heavy.
It's mainly just fat.
Yes, it shows so much.
Yeah, it's got miracles.
I get IVs. That's all it looks like. I get IVs of muscle milk.
It's got to stay. It's not too heavy to send it in.
I pull up the pictures. Okay, I take it. I'll get ready.
It's like, here's when you different number. And stuff.
I can teach her a table later.
Yeah, I saw that. I mean, that's made me think
about it.
this time.
That's true.
Our five should be fresh.
He's gonna do good.
Welcome to head coach Jeremy Pruitt's post-practice media availability. Coach will start us off an opening statement. Please raise your hands. We're calling you for questions. Coach?
You know, after we watched the film as a staff and watched it with our players, I think there was a lot of lessons learned for everybody, including the coaching staff and the players. You know, when guys done it the right way, they had success. When we didn't, the other side had success. So the key to the drill is find a way to do it right all the time, understand what to do. You know, made a lot of mental errors in the scrimmage, missed some tackles, had a few turnovers. But I thought today after watching the film, watching it with the players, I felt like our players practiced a little bit with a purpose today. You know, the last probably two or three times that we have practiced, to me, we've kind of competed the right way. Not the entirety of the practice, but for the most part, you know. And so what we've got to do is when we get to that point, we got to get guys where they start trying to get the other guys going instead of the coaching staff, because obviously we're not going to be out there during the game. So that's part of learning how to play football. It's part of learning how to be a team. So hopefully in the next 5 days we can start having some guys that step up and find a way to get everybody else going. So, any questions?
Brandon Rob.
Coach, obviously, we talked a lot about the experimenting of guys in different positions to start spring. Looked like you're doing that again today. Can you talk a little bit about moving some of those guys around the last couple weeks of practice here?
Yeah, you know, we switched a lot of guys to begin with. And we said we were going to go 7 days. We got to 7 days, and we felt like we needed to see a little bit more. After we scrimmaged, you know, there's several guys out there that we actually changed sides of the ball. You know, for instance, Fant went from playing running back, which he had never played, to now we put him at inside linebacker. Lante Taylor has went from wide receiver, which he was a high school quarterback, to now he's playing corner. We took three defensive linemen and moved them to offense. I had to think here. We moved a bunch of them. So y'all probably know more than I do. But to me, you know, we lack depth on the offensive line. So we do have some guys, just common sense. You got, you know, nine defensive linemen, and you're only playing three at a time. You got six offensive linemen. Find the guys who've played offense. Let's get them over there. Let's get them some work for the next, you know, couple of days. Let's see at least they have a foundation, you know, and possibly they can be an emergency down the road. You know, this isn't going to be a final switch for Alante Taylor. We're trying to develop depth and competition in the secondary, you know, and there may be a point sometimes in the season we had it this past year, you lose five guys at one position. You know, we still play on Saturdays, right? So we got to find a way. So if you're going to do that type of stuff, right now's the time to do it. To me, it's like I told Alante before we went out there. I said, I realize you have no idea what you're doing. Coach Farrah's going to tell you every snap. And you do it to the best of your ability. I said, I can tell whether or not you can play at that position one day just by your movements, you know. So we're doing some of that. So that's not going to – obviously, if you've got offensive linemen that have practiced one practice and, you know, you're throwing, you know, 10 days worth of install at them, they're not going to be very good. So we tried to scale back today when those guys were in to give them a chance, just so we can kind of see and evaluate, you know, moving forward.
Rob and Steve.
Coach, you said you would need to see tape in the scrimmage on Saturday before you got more depth. It sounds like you at least, you know, liked a couple of things. Anything, you know, for instance,
you were critical of the tackling on Saturday after watching the tape. Was it, did you see anything you liked for the running backs or vice versa after you kind of getting into it?
You know, it's kind of when you sit there and you're putting in, I'll start with defense, okay? Defensively, sometimes defensively you might not play very well, but you have success because it takes a lot more moving parts on the offensive side of the ball. Sometimes when you look at the end result on the offensive side, it may not be as good or bad as you think it is. You know, sometimes you may not block a soul, but the running back runs for 30 yards. You know, the next time, you know, you may block everybody, and the guy runs up there and don't make a very good run, makes the wrong cut. So, from the scrimmage, there was a lot of that. You know, we ain't got 11 guys doing and playing what we think is winning football. You know, everybody says winning football, that's what it is, you know. So we know what that standard is and what that expectation is, and our kids are understanding that. So to me, I think, you know, most of the time you probably watch teams, they improve more from the first game to the second game. You know, I think today, considering we swapped a lot of guys around, I thought our guys improved from a little more physicality, a little more run to the ball. You know, for the first time since I've been out there on the field, I tried to make sure I was out of the way. You know what I'm saying? So I had to get out of the way, and I had to back up. So that's a good thing.
Steve and Patrick.
On your defense, just in terms of just understanding the scheme semantic changes, how have they caught on in that regard?
Yeah, I don't think it's very hard to play our defense. You know, we teach basically 8 concepts, and that's really for the linebackers and the secondary. And to me, if you're going to play a 2-eye, the same as a 3 technique, 4-eye, 5, I mean, technique's technique, you know. So either you're playing technique or you're moving. You know, at the end of the day, like I told Princeton, you ain't going to know one call. I'm not worried about it. Let the coaches holler and scream at you. I said, when the ball's turned over, find the guy with the ball. Let me see you go thud his butt up, okay? I mean, that's really what football is. We'll coach the rest of it as you have a chance to learn. So sometimes I think we make it a little harder than what it really is.
Patrick, Jeremy, I think the only 2 guys that changed positions you did miss were Bird and then Bumpus. Kind of what did Bird, I guess, show or not show at safety that led him coming back to the wide receiver? And then Bumpus, I guess, is one of your biggest bodies at tight end. Why did he, I guess, go over the defensive line?
So it's a good point there. Well, for one, you know, Bumpus has a chance. He might have played defense in high school. I mean, hey, we want to figure out who the best players are, right? And I go back to my high school background. You know, sometimes you had to play guys on both sides of the ball, you know. Hey, when it comes down to the last 2 minutes, I'd like to have the best players on the field. You know, if we lose 2 or 3 guys at a certain position and we need to make some moves to figure out the best way, maybe have to change who we are, then we want to be able to do that. We don't want it to be October, November, the first time that they've ever done it. Does that make sense? So we want to give them a little bit of background. We'll have an idea if they can do it. Plus, it will help us when we get these new guys that come in, you know. And it helps, too. I mean, you know, there's some guys out there that can you talk about grad transfers? I mean, there's people out there that are grad transfers that may be looking to leave. We need to know what the heck we need and what we don't need, you know? So move some guys around.
Jesse, Blake, Austin.
Jeremy, you said you wanted to wait to kind of evaluate the quarterbacks until you've got to see the film, similar to some of the other things you've already kind of spoken about. But when you were able to kind of rewind the tape and watch, what did you see from Jarrett and Will in the live scrimmage setting that they were then able to take to practice today?
You know, I think the biggest thing is with both of them is, you know, you're never going to play perfect. No player is. So, and we talk to our guys all the time. There's no perfect players, no perfect coaches. You got to be able to play the next play. You know, if you throw a 60-yard touchdown, what you going to do the next snap? You know, if you turn the ball over, if you don't make the right check, you know, if you play very poorly in the first quarter, is that going to affect how you play the next 3 quarters? You know, to me, the biggest thing about playing quarterback, you know, how do you affect your teammates? At the end of the day, the bottom line is we want to take the football and go put it in the end zone. You know, so you got to get all 11 guys. Some guys have a way about them that can get the other guys to play at their best. I think that's things that make, you know, probably the best quarterbacks who's ever played. That's what separates them. You know, all quarterbacks, they wouldn't be playing a position if they didn't have arm talent. It's a blessing if they have foot talent, which both of these guys do. Both guys are smart. They're good competitors. But the key of the drill is hey, who's going to get the other guys to let's go and play at their best?
Blake and Austin.
Here we have two questions. One, I haven't seen Devontae Brooks and Riley Locklear out there, I think, for a few practices. Are they dealing with something right now? And then two, I noticed you mentioned after the scrimmage that you didn't make any calls. Is Coach Shear making the defensive calls then?
Yeah, when we go out there at practice, Kevin's making the calls. You know, Tyson's calling them on offense. But the thing about our staff, if we said Tracy Rocker, you make the calls, he could make the calls. If we said Chris Rump, you make the calls, he could make them. Charles Kelly's been making them for a long time. You know, same thing. Will Friend, he could call the offense. Chris Winkie could call the offense. You know, I didn't say Terry, I didn't say David, and I didn't say Brian. Not because they're not capable, they've just not worked in this system before. Does that make sense? So the other guys are very familiar with what we want to get done, how we want to do it. So, and they're very, all of them, all 10 of them are very involved in our daily planning.
And then Devontae and Riley.
I skipped that.
Mike?
You mentioned that the orange and white game was going to be a true game. Are you going to have any blitz limits or anything like that for your defense, or is it going to be wide open? And also, will that apply to next Saturday's scrimmage?
Well, we're going to format it, you know, so it's exciting, I hope, you know. I want to, you know, we're going to take from things, places we've been before. The last 4 minutes of each half, it's going to be 2 minutes. The last 4 minutes of the second half, it's going to be 2 minutes. Don't matter the score. So it's going to be 2 minutes back and forth. Okay. So, you know, there's a little bit of excitement. Nobody wants to go out there and watch you run zone or power over and over and over, set on the clock. So we want to play, put our players in position to compete. And, yeah, we're not going to go out there do everything, but heck, we don't do a whole lot anyhow on either side of the ball. So
I guess just to follow up on that, there are different ways. Some teams draft, some teams let the coaches. Have you figured out how you guys are going to split the team up yet? Or
yeah, we're going to play ones versus ones, you know, so it'll be, you know, the one offense will be on one team, the one defense will be on another team. With the one offense will be the two defense, and with the one defense will be the two offense. So we got good on good, and play it that way. You know, you can draft if you've got a team that's a lot of veterans, knows what's going on, and you have a lot of depth, which we do not. So you don't want to have one guy get injured. You know, you have to play a guy at left tackle and he can't block me, so every time the quarterback drops back to pass, we get sacked, so that's not going to be a whole lot of fun.
Austin, the last.
Jeremy, you talked about body language coming out of Saturday. With the position changes today, do you feel like you're able to get kind of a good mental makeup of, you know, what your players are like because you're switching them positions as far as body language when you give them that news? And then, two, can you talk about Daryl Taylor this spring?
You know, it's funny you talk about body language. I threw out the first pitch the other night at the baseball game, and I threw it about 6 yards left of home plate. I mean, we've got a catcher back there, and he can't even get over there to it. It's so far left. So my wife calls me after the baseball game. She said, hey, Coach Pruitt. I said, yes, ma'am. She said, if you're going to preach about body language, how about demonstrating it yourself? She said, you threw that ball and up against the backstop, you should have seen you walking off the field. So she straightened me out real fast on that pitch. But
you ask a bunch of questions, Eric. I can start back with the other one. Which one was?
Well, just what can you learn from telling a kid that they're going offensive line to defensive line as far as body language? And then Daryl Taylor.
Well, some of these guys, changing positions, you line up on the goal line, you may want to put defensive linemen down as tight ends. Heck, we might want to play with nothing but offensive linemen and tight ends. We might not want to play with any wide receivers. So, it don't matter how many offensive linemen are healthy. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So we're going to find a way to play the way we want to play. And if we got to play some guys that have to do both, we'll do that in certain situations. You ask about Daryl Taylor. Daryl has done a good job this spring. He seems to be willing to learn. He needs to improve on how he plays on special teams, I can tell you that. I told him that after the scrimmage. He's done some good things on defense, from rushing the quarterback and was stout at the end of the line, but running down on the punt team, he couldn't run no faster than me. That's not how we want to practice.
Less than David and Mike Wilson.
Jeremy, you were mentioning Daryl Taylor on special teams. How about the kicking game in general, kicker and punter? Have you been able to get a better look at those guys the past couple weeks and where y'all are at there?
Hey, we've been doing special teams every day. A lot of it we've done in the scrimmage. We've got to improve just like every position. We've got to get better with our snappers, better with our holders. We got some new holders, got some new specialists. So, like I told those guys out there today, I'm going to be at the game. So, I don't need to make you nervous, guys.
I was also going to ask about Cortez Sapp. Sorry. He's a guy who's gotten physically bigger, looks like, since last year. And, he'd been kind of an outside backer, now maybe doing more of the inside thing. How's he performing there? Or learning yet, I guess?
We've had a bunch of guys that have grown in the offseason. One of the reasons that we practiced on Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday was to live 3 days a week, because we felt like we need to grow physically. And, I think Corte was he was 211 pounds when we got here. And so that was in January. So I think the other day I saw his weight, he was like 226. So that's good. That's a testament to him, because not everybody's done that. So some of the guys, it goes back to guys that prepare, the guys that go in there and study film on their own. Some of it's got to do with your diet and your sleep, as much as it does with what you eat.
David?
Jeremy, to have Chance Hall back wearing a football uniform just a month after surgery, is that an encouraging sign, and what's his road to recovery look like?
Well, no, I'm expecting for them all to be back after they have surgery, pretty quick. Chance wants to play. It was kind of unusual when I first got here. Me and him had a conversation, for him. It's been a while since he had played, and I didn't really know his story. So we sat down and talked, and I think Chance is adamant. He's fired up about having an opportunity to get back out there, and that's good to see. We need him back, and we've got several guys that are, if we practiced in another week, for two more weeks, we would have a bunch of guys that would be cleared to practice, but we don't. So it is what it is, and we've got guys who have started mixing in out there in practice, maybe not full contact. So it's good for them to get some reps.
Mike Wilson.
Jeremy, you mentioned the other day not liking the level of pop you receive from your players. As part of moving guys like Matthew and Greg to the offensive line, looking for more of that out of that group?
No, moving those guys is based off need, because they've all played offensive line before, and we may move other guys next week, so let those guys play defense and move some other guys, and same thing at all the positions. We're trying to learn concepts, we're trying to learn how to block, tackle, we're trying to learn how to compete, how to play with effort all the time. You talk about pop. I said it a while ago. It's the first time I needed to get out of the way today, which is a good thing. So you know, most of the great players, probably the guys that are along these walls around here, I bet you, you know, Coach Fulmer and Coach Majors and Coach Dickey, Coach Nealon, I bet you they didn't have to get them to go. I bet you when he went out there to practice football, they were ready to practice. They might not have wanted to go to school. They might not want to do a lot of things. But when it comes time to play football, the real football players show up.
Any more questions? Thank you, Coach.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you, Coach.